So, Mr. Vice President, how confident are you in winning Wisconsin?
I never take anything for granted. I've worked really hard to try to earn the votes of the folks in Wisconsin. I've been there a number of times. And, you know, there's early in-person voting starting right today in Wisconsin. So the polls show this a close race, but with having a steady lead. And, you know, the fact is that we're in a situation where you can go and vote now. You can register and start voting today in Wisconsin. So I ask you to look me over. If you like what you see, help me out. If not, vote for the other person. But give me a look. And I'd suggest everybody go to iwillvote.com/WI. And to figure out where and how you're going to vote. Most importantly, vote early.
When it comes to the coronavirus here, Wisconsin is unfortunately making national headlines. For coronavirus numbers, hospitalizations have reached a record high. As president, what would you do on day one, the first thing to get coronavirus under control in states like Wisconsin?
Take responsibility. This president says it's not his responsibility. The federal government's role is to have a national response to tackle this national pandemic. But Donald Trump took no responsibility, failed and continues to fail to do that. He's still downplaying it, lying about it, denying how we have a big problem. We don't have one, he says. The cases in Wisconsin are surging, and the U.S. is now on track to double our death rate within the next few months. Over 200,000 dead already. What we've seen from Donald Trump is pure recklessness. No longer is a president even remotely responsible. The longer he's there, the more reckless he gets. He held what Dr. Fauci calls super spreader events at the White House, infected countless people, and then he blamed Gold Star families for him getting sick because they want to hug him. And he still refuses to wear a mask as if it's some kind of political statement. Donald Trump says we've turned the corner, that the vaccine is near, that he has a cure. But that's the same man who told us that the virus would go away by last Easter. He said it would go away when it got warm. And now he's telling us, don't worry, it's going to go away like a miracle. He still doesn't have a plan, but I do. I put my plan out in March. You can read it all online. Go to joebiden.com. And it starts with a mask mandate nationwide. His own people tell him that could save 100,000 lives between now and the end of the year. And I'm going to fix the testing fiasco he has so he can get to work safely, have tests that he gets quick responses on, provide protective gear for nurses, doctors, first responders. I'm going to provide funding and clear guidance. I've laid it out in July for our schools and our businesses so they can reopen safely. We're going to promote vaccines and treatments based on science, not politics. It's about telling the American people the truth. As you know, Adrienne, he knew how dangerous this was back on January the 28th. He told in an interview on tape, he had a taped interview with Bob Woodward saying he knows how dangerous it was. He didn't say a word to the American people. Didn't tell us at all. And he said when asked why he wouldn't do that, he said because he didn't want to panic the American people. He panicked. Imagine how many more people would be alive today, if he had told the truth in the beginning.
And Mr. Vice President, I want to get to two more quick questions while I have you. So for the debate on Thursday, what do you think of this new muting the mic rule?
I think it's a good idea. I think there should be more limitations on us not interrupting one another. If you notice, last time, according to Chris Wallace, he interrupted the president and me 148 times. I think that's right. Chris Wallace and me 148 times. And so I hope he's going to come prepared to talk about what he's for. But my guess is he's kind of signaling that it's all going to be about personal attacks, and because he doesn't want to talk about why he's taking away health care at the very time we're in the middle of a pandemic, why he has no plan for health care, why he hasn't provided the money to allow businesses to have the ability to reopen, why he's not dealing with unemployment, et cetera. But I'm going to try very hard to focus on the issues that affect the American people and talk to them. And I hope they keep the rule that uninterrupted 2 minutes answers.
Adrienne, that's all the time we have.
I just have one more question, because Mr. Vice President, it affects Wisconsin.
So Wisconsin's Republican Senator Ron Johnson put out a statement on Homeland Security letterhead saying Hunter Biden, together with other Biden family members, profited off the Biden name. Is there any legitimacy to Senator Johnson's claims?
None whatsoever. This is the same garbage Rudy Giuliani, Trump's henchman. It's a last-ditch effort in this desperate campaign to smear me and my family. Even the man who served with him on that committee, the former nominee for the Republican Party, said there's no basis to this. And, you know, and the vast majority of the intelligence people have come out and said there's no basis at all. Ron should be ashamed of himself.
Thank you. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.